the posterior cranial fossa. The posterior cranial fossa is largest and deepest fossa. This fossa contains hindbrain comprising pons, medulla oblongata in front and cerebellum behind. Boundaries: anteriorly superior border of petrous temporal and posterior part of body of sphenoid called dorsum cellae. Posteriorly squamous part of occipital bone and on the sides mastoid part of temporal bone. Floor: in the median area, sloping area behind dorsum cellae, foramen magnum in between and squamous part of occipital bone behind. Lateral area, lateral part of occipital bone, posterior surface of petrous temporal bone and mastoid temporal bone. Features: clivus is sloping area in front of foramen magnum. It supports pons and medulla oblongata. Foramen magnum: it is the largest foramen of skull. It is narrow in front and wider behind. Behind foramen magnum is internal occipital crest. On each side of the crest lie the cerebellar hemispheres. Internal occipital protuberance is grooved on each side by beginning of transverse sulci containing transverse venous sinuses. These sulci continue as sigmoid sulci lodging the sigmoid venous sinuses. Lateral area: hypoglossal canal present laterally with the hypoglossal nerve. Condylar canal containing an emissary vein. Posterior surface of petrous temporal shows a very important internal acoustic meatus. This is 1 centimeter long and runs laterally. And it gives passage to 7th nerve, 8th nerve and the labyrinthine vessels. Orifice of aqueduct of vestibule is a narrow slit behind internal acoustic meatus. The jugular foramen lies close to posterior end of junction of petrous and occipital bone. It gives exit to 9th, 10th and 11th nerves and to beginning of the internal jugular vein, which is the continuation of the sigmoid venous sinus. Finish.